My master is here.
Back your cavalry and leave this matter to me.
I pray you retire unharmed to Damascus. Reynald of Châtillon will be punished. I swear it. Withdraw, we will all die here. Do we have terms?
We have terms. I will send you my physicians.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
We have established that the origins of Freemasonry stem from ancient Babylon, which then made its way to Jerusalem, according to Masonic history. So how did the craft end up in Europe? Were the stonemasons really the originators of Freemasonry, or even the first Masons? How did these European stonemasons, or operative Masons, get their hands on something that was founded in the Middle East? Or were the stonemasons of Europe used as a cover or a scapegoat by someone else to be able to maintain their secret order? Let us examine this very carefully and trace back the correct history of the Freemasons. Pay very close attention to the following.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
ولما جاءهم رسول من عند الله مصدق لما معهم نبذ فريق من الذين أوتوا الكتاب كتاب الله وراء ظهورهم كأنهم لا يعلمون. واتبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان وما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقولا إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وما هم بضارين به من أحد إلا بإذن الله ويتعلمون ما يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ولقد علموا لمن اشتراه ما له في الآخرة من خلاق ولبئس ما شروا به أنفسهم لو كانوا يعلمون ولو أنهم آمنوا واتقوا لمثوبة من عند الله خير لو كانوا يعلمون.
Let us analyze the Quranic verses we've just heard. Many occult organizations, Satanists, Kabbalists, Freemasons, and many others attribute false accusations against Prophet Solomon, may the peace and blessings of God be upon him. A book, titled The Gosha, The Lesser Key of Solomon the King, first appeared in the 17th century, but much was taken from texts of the 16th century, including the Pseudomonarchia Daemonum, by Johann Weyre, and late medieval grimoires. It is likely that books by Jewish Kabbalists and mystics were also inspirations, and I will shortly explain further, as to where exactly this knowledge has come from. Some of the material in the first section of the book, concerning the summoning of demons, dates to the 14th century and even earlier. The book claims that it was originally written by King Solomon, although this is certainly incorrect. The titles of nobility assigned to the demons were unknown in his time, as were the prayers to Jesus, may the peace and blessings of God be upon him, and the Christian Trinity included in the text. The Gosha contains detailed descriptions of spirits and the conjurations needed to invoke and oblige them to do the will of the conjurer, referred to as the exorcist. It details the protective signs and rituals to be performed, the actions necessary to prevent the spirits, we will refer to these spirits as jinn, for the correct terminology, from gaining control, the preparations prior to the invocations, and instructions on how to make the necessary instruments for the